Alright everyone, this is it. The end of the road with Bed Bath & Beyond. Let's go inside and take a look one final time.
Closing soon, and you are saving. Everything is 50 to 70% off the lowest ticketed prices. Everything must be sold, even store fixtures. New price cuts, new merchandise, final leash to save in stores. Act fast, the savings won't last. Stores are fully stocked and ready to shop with bigger discounts and bigger selections. Shop now and save 50 to 70% off store-wide before it's too late. Bed Bath & Beyond stores closing soon. Use your camera to scan the code to find a store near you.
As many of you may know, all remaining Bed Bath & Beyond stores that were liquidating shut their doors for the final time as of August 13th, 2023. And since then, the online store for Bed Bath & Beyond has been purchased by Overstock.com, which leaves all remaining brick and mortar Bed Bath & Beyond stores to fend for themselves. Many of them sit abandoned, and many of them have since been repurposed or are actively being repurposed. But let's go back in time to 2021, when it was still just the early stages of Bed Bath & Beyond's problems. Let's go back to my very first Bed Bath & Beyond video, which took place at the mall at Grease Ridge in Grease, New York. So as you are aware, and to longtime subscribers of my channel, you know that this video right here is where it all began in the Bed Bath & Beyond series. On my channel was the liquidating one in Grease, New York, but we will go through the timeline and recap on several locations that I have covered over the course of the past 2 years leading up until the very last time I ever stepped foot in a Bed Bath & Beyond store. But first, we're going to just recap on the closing stores I filmed prior to the bankruptcy, which, as you can see just in this video alone, Bed Bath & Beyond used to use their own style of closing signs, but you will see later on in the video, as Bed Bath & Beyond loses money, they switch to signs used by Hilco, which is a liquidation company which basically took over all the brick and mortar locations. Now, a few other select locations I'm going to feature in this section of the video are the Bed Bath & Beyond stores in Erie, Canandaigua, and Niagara Falls. So, at this point, around April of 2023, Bed Bath & Beyond has filed for bankruptcy, and initially they planned on just closing about half of their portfolio, but later on would decide to close all remaining brick-and-mortar stores to focus solely on their online portfolio. They would be originally filing for bankruptcy protection, but it eventually would go to Chapter 11 and then Chapter 7 bankruptcy. The bankruptcy would not only impact Bed Bath & Beyond stores, but would also impact Bye Bye Baby stores, and would be devastating tons of shopping centers across the U.S., as many of them used Bed Bath & Beyond and or Bye Bye Baby as their leading anchor stores. At this point, you will also notice that the store closing signs are no longer the red ones that Bed Bath & Beyond custom made. This is because Hilco has taken over operations of liquidating each of the brick and mortar stores, the same company that liquidated all remaining Lord & Taylor stores back in late 2020. The following Bed Bath & Beyond stores I will be featuring in this section of the video are the Hamburg one, which is being shown right now, the Amherst store, and the Henrietta Bed Bath & Beyond store. Thank you. most of my memories with Bed Bath & Beyond were scattered throughout the years, but I do recall being in there with my mother several occasions as we were looking for different home goods. Sometimes we would come out with a bag or two, sometimes we didn't find what we were looking for. But I can say the stuff that we did get was quite durable and we still use it to this day. Another thing that always brought my mom to these stores were those Bed Bath & Beyond coupons, because without them, prices were a little bit on the rougher side, but with those coupons, it made pretty much anything in that store seem like it was a great deal. And I'd also like to add that the very last time I was ever inside of the Hamburg Bed Bath & Beyond store, I did purchase a small Keurig coffee maker that currently sits in the mall's break room because we've never had a coffee maker in there, so it's really nice that we have one now. I use it a lot, and I know a lot of my coworkers with the mall do. It's just something nice in a way to see Bed Bath & Beyond's memories live on. So this store was probably the most significant store to me because this was the store I did the most visits to for my Bed Bath & Beyond series. I did about 4 or 5, maybe even 6 updates, I don't even remember. But this store, I was pretty much here every week from when they announced closing pretty much until the last day. I was able to get cool shots of them disassembling the store, and I actually was able to retrieve a couple of things from the dumpster after the store closed. I will show you that later in the video. But all in all, I think this store was the most sentimental to me watching it close, just because of the amount of updates I did. In a more personal note though, I'm obviously gonna say the Hamburg store is the saddest one to see go, because that was my childhood store. And, you know, it's part of the McKinley Mall, which I work at the McKinley Mall. Of course I don't wanna see stores leaving there. But definitely this Amherst location played a huge role on my channel and the Bed Bath & Beyond series. So by this point, Bed Bath & Beyond stores have been finishing up their liquidation sales and locking their doors for the final time, leaving employees to go in and disassemble the shelving units and all remaining fixtures that were in the store, which begs the question, what is going to happen with all these vacant spaces? Well, I believe some of them are going to get filled. They actually had auctions and several retailers, including Burlington and Market by Macy's, bought out some of the leases. But for a lot of stores, including all of them in Western New York, are sitting abandoned right now, waiting to see what happens next. Some of them are temporarily being used for Spirit Halloween stores, but other than that, what is the next step with these spaces? Alright guys, I thought I'd just show you a lot of the stuff that Bed Bath & Beyond just threw out in their dumpster. For example, look at all this. Here, maybe I have to get a better view from the top. But, look at all this stuff that they just left behind. Just threw it all out. Especially a lot of these big signs too. There's one in particular that I wanted, but I don't see it in here. I'll do a little bit of looking, but if I can't find it, I can't find it. So guys, wish me luck. All right guys, so I wasn't able to recover much, but I did get a few cool things, so yeah. Like I said guys, I hope you enjoyed these updates, and you know, I'm gonna be back in a little bit to show my some drone footage. So at this point now, all stores are done liquidating and have locked their doors. And at this point, landlords are now going through and taking down whatever Bed Bath & Beyond has left up, including this sign, which is outside of the Amherst store. I will give credit to Alex from Retail Adventures with Alex for taking this footage right here. It was pretty cool to get a look at the sign actively being dismantled off the building. So I got the honor of taking this sign off of the mall entrance at the McKinley Mall. I took these photos basically documenting the progress of the sign being taken off. If you were wondering, no, the sign did not go in the garbage. It actually went to Retail Adventures with Alex, who plans on storing it somewhere safe and potentially displaying it in the future. Some Bed Bath & Beyond stores are more fortunate than others in terms of getting filled. This one was one of the more unfortunate locations and is still abandoned to this day. This is the Bed Bath & Beyond that was in Cheektowaga. This closed in, I want to say, 2017 maybe. It's been vacant ever since. I was lucky enough to get a look inside of the store. The general layout is kind of how all Bed Bath & Beyond stores were. Some of them were a little bit more different than other ones, but they all generally looked like this. It was just pretty cool to get a look at what one looked like without all the shelving and fixtures in the way. It was crazy walking in this shell of a store, knowing that at one point Bed Bath & Beyond had over 1,500 locations across the U.S., and now all of them just look like this or are in the process of being redeveloped.
Alright guys, we're back with another video. This is a new location of Spirit Halloween. Actually used to be down the plaza that way, but for some reason they moved, and I think it's because there was a little bit of water damage. This is now...
Let's go check this store out.
We are now looking at that same Cheektowaga Bed Bath & Beyond location 1 year later in the late summer, early fall of 2022. This was one of my Spirit Halloween episodes, and it was cool to see the Bed Bath & Beyond temporarily repurposed. Sadly, the Spirit is not going back into this location again, but it was nice that this store at least got 1 year of life before it ended up sitting vacant again.
Now, I don't know if you guys are aware of this, but I got to see this place when it was still abandoned, and it was really cool to be in here. That was a while ago, though. You can go check that video out. Alright guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video. As always, remember to like, comment, and subscribe.
So you heard me share my stories and memories with Bed Bath & Beyond, but now let's take a listen to what some other people have to say about the store.
Hello everybody, this is Retail Adventures with Alex and Bed Bath & Beyond. What it meant to me? Well, it meant many things. It was at my mall and I would go there all the time. And I remember there was two particular things that I used to buy there that I still have to this day. A chess set and an Atari. And they always had amazing deals, I'll say that. And I would always walk around in there, you know. And I also had a friend of mine I went to high school with who also worked there, so I would go there and just chill with him, and I always enjoyed it, and I also bought many things from my parents over the years, you know, both during the clothing sale and when it was not closing, and they both are going to use it for many years to come, so Bed Bath & Beyond will be in our house for many years to come, and they always had really good products, and it's disappointing to see that they're gone now, but they definitely mean a lot to me, and I'll always remember them as a great company. And a member of my mall.
My favorite memories of going to Bed Bath & Beyond is when I used to go with my father to get some party supplies for Easter, Halloween, New Year's Eve, Christmas, Thanksgiving, and 4th of July at the Victor, New York location.
Hi, my name is Jeremy from Jeremy's Retail Exploration, and my favorite memories from Bed Bath & Beyond is when they were going out of business, and I was driving all around to visit the closing sales. I went to stores in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Maryland, and Delaware, and throughout those locations I got a lot of cool stuff. I remember my location in York, Pennsylvania when it was closing and how much stuff I bought from there. Just a really crazy time when they were in the liquidation process, and I am glad we all have a lot of locations on film to look back on in later years.
And with that, we're now back to the final day of Bed Bath & Beyond. This was the store in Williamsville, New York on its very last day. I was thankful to be able to see this store in its final moments of operation as an entire brick and mortar company. And it was sad, too, to see the amount of people that were here. Not everyone came to buy something. Some people just came to reminisce about a better time when this store was still an empire. Thank you. And with that, this video now comes to a close. I hope everyone enjoyed this video, and I want to thank each and every one of you who stuck around all the way to the end. It is a little bittersweet walking out of the store one final time, knowing that I will never be inside of a Bed Bath & Beyond store ever again. But I hope someday, maybe Overstock.com will consider reopening brick and mortar stores. But until then, farewell Bed Bath & Beyond, rest in peace.